Good afternoon, everyone, once again. God bless, and we are now starting our second episode of this sharing of the Word of God. And hi to all UPC Agdao Church and to all the saints that can monitor and follow this broadcast. Thank you very much for the privilege of sharing the Word of God this afternoon. And we need the Word of God, my brethren. And it's very important, lalo na po ngayong panahon na ito na karamihan sa mga tao ay nasa bahay lamang at walang ginagawa. And maybe madami kayong nasa isip nyo na gusto nyong gawin, but God has a plan for everything. Minsan hindi natin maintindihan, pero yun palang mga nangyayari sa buhay natin, mga kapatid, ay meron din namang the best na plano ang Panginoon. Maybe before, hindi tayo nakapaglinis sa bahay natin, sa buong paligid, but now we have an ample time to clean sa lahat ng kapaligiran natin sa bahay. At maybe you have no time for your family before, and right now, you have that ample time of playing with your children, and nakapagkwentuhan na kayo ng mga kapamilya mo, mga kapatid. At ito talaga is sometimes hindi natin makomprehend yung plano ng Panginoon, pero sa bawat cycle ng life natin, mga kapatid, may the best talaga na gina-prepare yung ating Panginoon para sa atin. So ngayon, I will share to you the Word of God according to 1 Peter chapter 1:5-8, mga kapatid. At just follow us. I'll try my best for Tagalog. Kahapon, Bisaya English tayo, mga kapatid. At nakita ko yung friend ko from my college times in Manila na nasa Amerika na ngayon. Hindi niya naintindihan yung Bisaya, no? But I'll try my best to share with you the Word of God. You know, every time we read the Word of God, it is the Lord who is talking to us. And ito yung panahon, mga kapatid, na talagang bigyan natin pansin yung spiritual side ng buhay natin. We're too much busy sa ating gawain, sa pagpapalago ng ating pamilya. But God reminding us that hindi po hanggang dito lang sa mundong ito ang gagawin natin o ang pagkakaabalahan natin o bigyang pansin, but lalo na at lalo na yung ating spiritual na side. And we know that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out from the mouth of God. Alright, so before we will read the Word of God, allow me to pray to all of us today or this afternoon as you close your eyes. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we are very privileged, Lord, to hear your word once again, and empower us, Lord God, even the heavenly wisdom and understanding. Continue to bless all the hearers of this word. Amen. Coming from you, empower them with your thoughts, Lord God, and wisdom. Thank you, Lord, for all the blessing, even, Lord God, the protection and the favor na ibibigay niyo po sa aming lahat sa hapong ito, in Jesus' name. Amen. So, in 1 Peter, my brethren, 1:5, the word of the Lord says, "And through your faith, God is protecting you by His power until you receive this salvation, which is ready to be revealed on the last day for all to see." Sa ibang version, "who are kept," King James, "by the power of God through faith unto salvation ready to be revealed in the last time." Sa Tagalog naman, nasa kapangyarihan ng Diyos ay iniingatan sa pamamagitan ng pananampalataya sa ikaliligtas na nahanda upang ihayag sa huling panahon. Ngayon, mga kapatid, we know that God empower us through our faith. Praise the Lord. Jesus, at the time that He rules this earth humanly, He said to his disciple in Mark 11:22, as he answered to them, he said, "Have faith with God." So it's very important to have that faith, because without faith, we cannot please God, according to Hebrews 11:6. Faith is our connection to God. We need that faith. In this world, we rely on our own thinking, on our own perception, on our own knowledge, and power and capability. But all of that is to no avail without our faith with God. Without entrusting our life, our mind, our heart to our God. So, faith is important, my brethren, because this will connect us that God will empower, even the protection of the Lord will be given to us. It's very important. Kailangan po talaga natin ng pananampalataya. Kahit ano ka paman, sa simula, nang isinilang ka, kung hindi ka pa nakabasa sa Word of God, at ngayon lang nakaroon ng time to read the Word of God, then today, you will start to have that faith, trusting the Lord. Kailangan po talaga natin, mga kapatid, nahahawakan yung pananampalataya, kasi without that, God cannot empower us. Only faith that God can empower our life. So, saan po ba nanggagaling yung faith or yung pananampalataya? According to Romans 10:17, kaya nga, ang paniniwala'y nagagaling sa pakikinig, at ang pakikinig ay sa pamamagitan ng salita ni Kristo. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. So once you hear the Word of God, that faith starts to grow in your life, my brethren. Maybe you have so many challenges in your life today, so many confusions, doubts, so many fear in your heart. But right now, I challenge you, have faith with God. Because that faith will save you. That faith will create miracles in your life. That faith with God will bring you to salvation, my brethren. Praise the Lord. So we need to live by faith. Romans 1:17 says, "For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. As it is written, the just shall live by faith." Sapagat dito ang katuwiran ng Diyos ay nahahayag po mula sa pananampalataya hanggang sa pananampalataya. Gaya ng nasusulat, ngunit ang ganap ay mabubuhay sa pamamagitan ng pananampalataya. So our righteousness from God will be revealed from faith to faith. In every challenges of our life, when we succeed, because of the intervention of God through our faith. And when we succeed for that situation, then another trials come in our life. God cannot empower us without that faith. Even you succeed before, you are victorious in your life before. And now, again, another challenges like this coronavirus that comes in the world. Hindi po hanggang doon lang ang miracles ng ating Panginoon. Hindi po hanggang doon lang siya gumagawa sa tao. Hanggang ngayon po, habang nandyan pa, humihinga tayo, meron tayong freedom to worship God, to call Him, establish your faith with God. Kailangan talaga nating i-connect yung ating pananampalataya sa ating Panginoon, mga kapatid. Praise the Lord. Sapagkat dito ang katuwiran ng Diyos ay nahahayag. mula sa pananampalataya hanggang sa pananampalataya. So from faith to faith, the just shall live by faith. So when you have that faith with God, we need to transform our mind. Paul encouraged us in Romans 12 that by the renewing of our mind, we can receive the transformation, and it empowers us through faith. So once you have that faith, you must hold on. And how to hold that faith in your life? You must rejoice. In 1 Peter 1:6, so be truly glad. There is wonderful joy ahead, even though you have to endure many trials for a little while. So our life today encounters trials, but when we think the goodness of God, there are positive side beyond these trials. But that positive side, that good things that will happen, only be revealed through faith with Christ. So hold on to your faith. I encourage you, my brethren, hold on to your faith. We need to safeguard our faith. We need to protect. Because once you deprive that spirit, then God cannot empower you. Na ito ang inyong totoong ikinagagalak, bagamat ngayoy sa sandaling panahon, kung kailangan, ay pinalumbay kayo sa mulit-muling pagsubok. So we're expecting this. Previous months, we encounter earthquake, volcanoes eruption, different challenges in our life, and right now, this coronavirus. But as a child of God, we have that faith, and we need to empower that faith. And through rejoicing in this difficult situation, we can claim to God. And only to God that we can hold on our life and entrust that our life, my brethren. So, dyan lang po sa ating Panginoon. Psalms 5:11 says, but let all those that put their trust in thee rejoice. Ngunit iyong pagalakin ng lahat ng nagsisipagkanlong sa iyo. So, every time we trust our faith to God, we need to rejoice. Why? It is a privilege. Dahil kapag tayo po ay masayang nananampalataya sa ating Panginoon and we trust our life to Him, then God can empower us. This word continue to say that let them ever shout for joy because Thou defendest them. Let them also that love Thy name be joyful in Thee. So, pahiyawin mo nawa sila sa kagalakan magpakailanman sapagkat iyong ipinagsasanggalang sila. Mangangagalak nawa rin sa iyo ang nagsisiibig ng iyong pangalan. How can I rejoice in this difficult situation? It is by faith that you trust the Lord, that in every difficult situation, there is the empowerment of God in your life. There is this word that we hold on. Naa ang iyahang pulong mga igsoon. The word of God continue to remind us that once we trust God, even in the difficult situation like this, we understand that everything is under the control of God's hands. So hold on. Rejoice. Hallelujah. Psalms 31:7 says, I will be glad and rejoice in thy mercy, for thou hast considered my trouble. Thou hast known my soul in adversaries. Wow. Ako'y matutuwa at magagalak sa iyong kagandahang loob, sabagkat iyong nakita ang aking kadalamhatian. Iyong nakilala ang aking kaluluwa sa mga kasakunaan. So every trials, God knows what is the end. But if you hold your faith believe God, obey His word, and rejoice, my brethren, then the protection of God will be upon you. His intervention, praise God, His protection, His love, His care will be given to you because you have that faith with God. We hold on our faith through the word of God. As I said, then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. 1 Peter 1:7, these trials will show that your faith is genuine. It is being tested as fire tests and purifies gold, though your faith is far more precious than mere gold. So when your faith remains strong through many trials, it will bring you much praise and glory and honor on the day when Jesus Christ is revealed to the whole world. In this situation right now, people are searching for someone that will empower them and strengthen their faith. And I believe you will be used by God because you have that faith. Allow that faith to grow in your life to become a blessing to everyone. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We are the light of this world as we hold on the light of Christ. So kailangan yung light natin, dala-dala natin mga kapatid, at makikita ng sambayanan, ng community, that even in this situation, there is someone, there is a family, there is a neighbor that are rejoicing for God's goodness and mercy in their life. Praise the Lord. Yung mga kapatiran natin ngayon na hindi connected sa government or hindi employed, that they receive their monthly salaries, eh, kasi yun, makaka-receive sila ng mga 13 month. Pero meron ding kagaya natin na walang ganun na privilege, no? They work, at kapag hindi sila nagtrabaho, wala silang makakain. So there's fear, no, in their heart, but this is the time that we nail down to God and establish our faith. Although the government prevent us, no, to go around outside our house, kung hindi man talaga importante, there is someone that will be used by God. Someone that will be touched by God. Maybe may kapatiran kayo, may kapitbahay kayo dyan na hindi masyadong nag-uusap, walang time to mingle with each other. But when you kneel down to God and pray, gagamit at gagamit ang Panginoon ng someone to establish the needs are needed right now, my brethren. But it will be only be fulfilled through faith. So kailangan talaga hawakin yung ating paniniwala na ang Panginoon patuloy na nag-empower sa bawat isa. Every trials of our faith, no, will be tested. So, gaano ka man tawag nito yung supply na nakukuha mo, nare-receive mo, yung abundance of all the blessings before na nare-receive mo mga kapatid, and right now, hindi mo na na-receive at wala na yung mga supply na ini-expect mo before. So just nail down to God and establish your faith. Just pray to God. Connect to God once again. Hallelujah. Because God is hunger of your prayer, and that prayer connect to your faith, then God will answer your prayer. It's very important to remind in the Old Testament, 2 Chronicles 7:14, that if my people humble themselves and pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. I will heal their lands. God will answer your prayers, my brethren. Believe me. Just hold on and establish your faith. Praise God. Lahat ng pagsubok sa ating pananampalataya, Amen, ay mahalaga dahil dito po tayo sinasalang ng Panginoon. How faithful we are in depending our faith to God. Praise the Lord. So believing the unseen God is very important. Peter said, you love Him even though you have never seen Him. Though you do not see Him now, you trust Him. And you rejoice with a glorious and inexpressible joy. Na hindi ninyo nakita ang inyong iniibig, na bagamat ngayon ay hindi ninyo siya nakikita, gayon may inyong sinasampalatayahan na kayo'y nagagalak na totoo, na may galak na di masayo at puspus ng kaluwalhatian. You're believing and depending on unseen God. One of disciple of Jesus in John 20:29, si Thomas, Jesus said, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed, but blessed are they that have not seen and yet have believed. Wow, praise the Lord. It's a privilege, even we do not see God, but we have that faith. We trust the Lord. How many times you are protected by God? How many times did God save your life? How many times did God repair your relationship? Acknowledge that. Because once you connect always to that faith, God will continue to bless you. God will continue to empower you. God will continue to give you all the protections, my brethren. Once you overcome, rewards are coming. The reward for trusting Him will be the salvation of your souls, according to 1 Peter 1:9. So once we trust the Lord and we endure all the trials with victories because we have that attitude of rejoicing always, giving praise to God, giving thanks to God, then salvation will come. Jesus continued to remind us, my brethren, that the Word of God is powerful. He continued to encourage us to believe on Him, to trust Him, regardless of the circumstances of this life. Praise God. So we need to be transformed to believe God. We need to have that faith. Amen. And establish that faith. But James reminds us that faith without work is dead. That is why it's very important to apply that faith into action. We need to kneel down and pray and give the wisdom and ask the wisdom from God. Then God will have that dominion to you through the Holy Spirit of the Lord. And God will continue to give you the answers of all the desires of your heart. So right now, my brethren, Peter empower us to have that faith with God. Because once you preserve that faith, amen, the ending is salvation of your souls. Our souls are hunger, the Word of God. Our soul are hunger of the intimate relationship with God. One night, Nicodemus came to Jesus because he want to enter and want to inquire regarding the kingdom of God. He knew that the Lord do the miracles. Then Jesus said unto him, according to John chapter 3, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. And because there are so many people like Nicodemus right now that are so full of wisdom and knowledge in this world, Nicodemus said, how can I enter into my mother's womb when I am old? Matanda na po ako, papasok pa ba ako sa tiyan ng nanay ko para ipanganak muli? But Jesus said, except a man be born again of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter and to the kingdom of God. That will be empowered by faith. Without understanding through faith with God, entrusting your life to God, you cannot comprehend. Again, when I am old, but Jesus remind us to be a born-again Christian through the water and of the Spirit. This is part of salvation. We need to receive the salvation coming from God. We need to receive Christ as our personal Savior. We need Christ to dwell in our life. We need Christ to transform us, to be reconnected again to His Spirit. We know that our body is a temple of God. And through faith, entrusting our life to God, God will protect our body. God will give us the wisdom. God will give us the power of that knowledge and understanding to comprehend the real essence of His salvation. So hold on to your faith. Praise God. Paul said in Galatians 3:27, that they that are baptized in Jesus have put on Christ. So we need to be covered by the name of Jesus. We need to be protected by the name of Jesus. Even Jesus follow and obey, amen, regarding that seal of baptism. He received that. Praise God. Because it's very important to obey. And that will be empowered by faith through God. So, just a slight word regarding that tonight, because we focus on faith. So you establish your faith, you hold on your faith to God, read the word of the Lord and ask the wisdom, God will guide you. God will empower you to be blessed by this time that everyone, lahat po, na-encounter ang mga problema, fear in their heart. But right now, we are empowered by the word of God through faith. So, kailangan po magtulungan tayo through prayers, encouragement with each other, maghawakan po ng mga kamay, na alam po natin yung strength natin nandyan sa bawat isa through the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And God will continue to guide us. God will continue to bless us, my brethren. So, Psalms 35:9 says, "And my soul shall be joyful in the Lord. It shall rejoice in His salvation. Ang aking kaluluwa ay magagalak sa Panginoon. Nagagalak na mainam sa Kanyang pagliligtas." So once you endured these circumstances, trials in life, salvations of God will come, then your soul will be joyful. You know what? Our soul will face God in judgment, not our body. This body will go back, to dust. But our soul will face God. Amen. So, David are rejoicing. Praise the Lord. That his soul will face God in salvation. Here's the promise of God. When we endure all the trials through faith with Christ and obeying His directives of salvation, as a part of that salvation, of course, we need to repent. No? We know that Jesus Christ instructed Peter in Matthew 16, 18 to 20, that Peter, upon this rock I will establish my church, that even the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And unto you I will give the keys of the kingdom of heaven. So, Peter are directed by God to have that case, no? So that malalaman natin kung paano ba makapasok sa kingdom of God. We know yesterday that we quote in Matthew 6:33 that man that seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. So, we need to understand the concept of the kingdom, entering that kingdom. And God instructed Peter to hold on that case to open up that door in the kingdom of God. But before God gave the authority, He said in Acts 1:8 that wait till the promise of the Holy Spirit come so that you have that power before you will share the good news to the world. So Peter wait for that promise in the upper room together with the 120 people. And after days that they pray and fast, then the Holy Spirit are poured out. And as we wrap up, the situation that the people are confused, asking with each other why they know their dialects and so forth. You can read that in Acts chapter 2. Amen. And too much for that, as Peter understand that they are confused, he preached the word of God because he's the one given the keys of the kingdom. So when Peter shared the goodness of God, the principles of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, the people in Acts chapter 2:37 pricked in their heart and asking, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said, repent. Take note that once the people are asking regarding the solution, they establish first faith. So Peter said, repent. Then receive the baptism and be baptized every one of you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. So, ang kapasailuan sa sala na sa pangalan ni Jesus Christ. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. So my brethren, that is connected in John chapter 3, that except a man be born again of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. So I connected it in Galatians 3:27, that everyone who are baptized Jesus have put on Christ. Amen. It's very important to put on the name of the Lord in our life so that we are protected, praise God, by the salvation of the Lord. Now, this is the promise of God when we endure. Sa dihang nakalahutay ta, sa dihang nagmadaugon ta mga igsoon. In Revelations 21, is the promise of the Lord. And I saw a new heaven and new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven, saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God. My brethren, this coronavirus is just temporary. The promise of God are at stake. Hold on to your faith. Praise God. Because everyone that will endure will receive this promise. Amen. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. Wow. And there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. So everything in this world is just temporary. Just establish your faith, search the Word of God, believe, obey the Word, accept the Lord as your personal Savior, be sealed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ by receiving in baptism in the name of the Lord for the remission of your sins. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Live a holy life. Continue to trust God, even in this situation. Praise God. And this promise will be given to you, my brethren. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. Wow. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. So everything will be changed to a new thing. And he said unto me, it is done. I am the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is thirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things. Wow, what a great promise from the Lord. He that overcometh shall inherit all things. Ang magtatagumpay at magmamana ng mga bagay na ito. Sino ang magtatagumpay? Siya ang magmamana sa lahat ng promises ng ating Panginoon. And I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Praise God. But here's the consequences. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and warmongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. So nakakatakot po mga kapatid. Lahat ng duwag, yung mga hindi mananampalataya, no faith, at sa mga kasuklam-suklam, at sa mga mamamatay tao, at sa mga mapakiapid, at sa mga manggagaway, at sa mga mapagsamba sa Diyos-Diyusan, at sa lahat ng mga sinungaling, ang kanilang bahagi ay sa kadagat-dagatang naniningas sa apoy at asupri na siyang ikalawang kamatayan. My brethren, when you accepted Jesus as your personal Savior and endured this thing, you will not receive the second death. God will preserve your life, your soul. God will save you, my brethren. So right now, hold on to your faith. Hold on to your faith. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Continue to trust the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In this situations right now, God continue to ask your heart. Trust Him directly. Believe in Him directly, my brethren. Call on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And God will save your soul. God will give you the promise, amen, of the everlasting life. So my brethren, tonight, anuman yung mga nasa dibdib mo, mga kapatid, fear, doubt, confusions, I will pray that faith will come in your life and to your family, and we continue to pray with each other. If there are many people that are negative right now, empower them through faith with Christ and believe that God will continue to give them the wisdom. Praise the Lord, and God will use you as a light, amen, in these difficult situations. I will pray for you. Most gracious Heavenly Father, continue to touch every heart of your people tonight as they listen and follow your words. Empower them through faith. Lord God, protect them and give them the heavenly wisdom and understanding, even the divine protection of their soul, their body, even their families. Continue to supply the basic needs, Lord God, in this difficult situation. We trust you, Lord God, that you will continue to pour out the blessing, amen, and prove to the people in this world that you are the one that we can trust, and wala pong ibang matatakbuhan namin, ikaw at ikaw lang po, Panginoon. Thank you, God, for empowering us through your word tonight. As we close this, I will declare, Lord God, by the authority of your words and in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let the healing power of your touch be upon all the people na may karamdaman ngayon. And even, Lord God, blessing and protection be upon us, Lord God, as we believe your words, sealed with your precious blood. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless everyone. See you the next time around. To God be the glory.